So today we are going to start with the basic introduction of a computer graphics. We will see the basic terminology related to computer graphics and the terms which we are using while we go through all the topics in this. Okay. So starting with the introduction, computer graphics is right now a most important part in the computer science, and in this we are dealing with the pictures, images, charts, moving objects, etc. So in this computer graphics we are dealing with how the pictures are stored, how we are representing them, how we are storing them, and how they are appearing on the screen. Okay, so first we will see the why we are using a computer graphics and what are the interactives which computer graphics is providing us. Okay, so first one is most important is communication. So computer graphics generally deal with the pictures and images, and it is a part of a communication between a user and a computer. So for the interaction purpose between a computer and a user, we are dealing with, we are using some medium which is a pictures, or it can be a moving object like animation. Okay. Secondly, it is providing us a tools. Computer graphics provide us a tools to store these images and to represent them and to use them in a further communication purpose. So third one is the control of objects. It deals with how the speed of the object or the motion of the object is controlled. How when we are applying some animation, what is the speed of the object, what, how it is represented in the screen. All these control tools are provided by computer graphics. Another one is in communication medium tools, it provides us the tools how we are representing with the help of CRT or the other devices these objects on the screen. Okay, so these are the basic some interactive tools which computer graphics provide us. Now we will go through the applications. So when we are dealing with applications of computer graphics, the first and the most important is user interface. As it is providing a communication channel between a user and a computer, so it act as an interface. So this is the most important role which a computer graphics play. Secondly, for the representation of data, charts, and how to represent the whole data, how to represent the whole data with the help of charts and the diagrams. Like in today's, we see that all the data which we are having, we can represent it with the help of the charts analysis. Like in elections, we can easily see that the whole data analysis is represented with the help of a pie chart, bar chart. This make our analysis more easier for the user to understand. Now, the third application is for the representation of the geographical maps, roads maps, routes maps, and the weather forecast. For all these representation, we are using some interactive tools. Like we see in Google Map, we are having some images and some tools which are representing all the routes which you are taking, all the paths we are considering. Now, another one is animation. As we know that in the entertainment industry, animation is the most important part right now, and in this animation purpose, for creating these animation objects and representing them and storing them, we are using computer graphics. Another one is this is also called cartography. This weather forecast and all the map images, all the things, these are generally called cartography. And another application is simulation. Simulation is when we are representing some object, real-time objects, or the like we are having some projects of ISRO and other to simulate them in a initial form. When we are designing them, when we are designing some instruments and other, we can simulate them before processing. And another one is CAD. CAD is a software computer aided design which is used for simulating the cars and other objects. It is generally used by mechanical engineers for plotting the a car diagram or any object in a software form. So in these are the basic applications of computer graphics. Except this, we are also having different areas in which we are using entertainment industries. These are the broad scopes. We are just initializing them. So these are the applications. So this is the basic diagram of the uses of computer graphics. We have categorized them in the different types of object, kinds of feature, type of interaction, and picture representation. When we are dealing with type of object, we have to specify which kind of representation we are doing. It can be a 2D, 3D, 4D, and another more dimensions. If it is depend on the kind of picture, then it is can be a symbolic or realistic. Means the object which you are representing, it is in a symbolic form or you are using some realistic images. We can also categorize them on the basis of type of interactions we are having, controllable and non-controllable. Controllable means if user is having a command to change the speed, to change the color, to change the other properties or features. Non-controllable means when user is not having any command over that. Then another one is pic representation, means how you are representing your picture. Either you are using some representation of line, circle or another image. Either your image is black and white or it is a colored image, and it can also consist of the other features. So this is the general representation of the uses of computer graphics on the basis of different features which we are taking. Before we will start the deep study of the other things, we should discuss one topic, but that is input devices and output devices. All the pictures which we are storing, all these are interacted with the help of devices. That it can be an input device and it can be an output devices. So we will see that what are the various input devices we are using. So first and the most common interactive input device which we are using while in a computer graphics is a basic is keyboard. Second one is mouse, touch screen, joystick, light pen, mouse. So these are the general input devices which we are using. A keyboard, which we will see in a computer or in a laptop for entering the data. Mouse is used for selecting the desired data which you are using. Touch screen is generally used in mobile phone for input of the data. Joystick is generally deals with the gaming purposes. In this, we are having our input device which will move to the left, right, and top and bottom. Light pen is also an input device in which we are having our input device as a pen, and the data which you will enter with the help of this pen will be stored in the digital form. And mouse is another input device. Now the most important are output devices, in which we are having the most important is monitor. Monitor, which is the screen in which you are seeing your graphical part. So in this, the most important part which generally we will cover is CRT. It is generally asked in the theoretical part in UGC NET, that is cathode ray tube. All the display devices are generally based on this cathode ray tube. Hence we should know the basic structure of this CRT. So we will discuss this in detail, that how this CRT is designed and how it is stored or represent the picture. So this is a basic diagram of a CRT cathode ray tube, which is used for the representation of an image on a screen. These are the basic parts of a CRT. We are having a connector pin, which is used to connect this CRT to implement on the device in which we are using this. This is the electron gun through which the electrons will be emitted and will be plotted on the screen. these electrons which will be emitted from the electron guns will get will touch this phosphorus coated screen, in which they will, after the striking on this screen, they will generate a light and which will form the object or a picture. We can control the speed of these electrons with the help of some focusing system and horizontal and vertical deflection plate. These plates are used that on which part of the screen we want our picture or our image, and focusing system is also a to focus this electron gun on this screen. This screen is coated with a phosphorus, having a phosphorus coating, so that when these electrons will strike on this screen, they will emit the light. In a CRT, there are two methods through which the image will be generated on the screen. First one is beam penetration method, and second one is shadow masking. In a beam penetration method, we are having a coating of two colors on this phosphorus coating side. So this will be the coating. One is of red color and the another one is green color. So the electrons which will be emitted from the electron gun, if they are having a low intensity, then they will strike only the red part, and if they are having a high intensity, then it will penetrate the red part and goes to the green part. If the frequency of these, speed of these electrons is in the middle of red and green, then the combination color of red and green will be formed. So it is generating four colors. These are red, green, orange, and yellow. The image which will form by beam penetration method will have only these four colors and the combination of these four. So the disadvantages of this beam penetration method is that the color range is fixed. We are having a less number of colors or images which will be formed. Also, it is cheaper technique. So it is used for those images in which we are not having our wide range of colors. Second one is shadow masking. In shadow masking, instead of one electron gun, we are using three electron guns, one for each color, R, G, B, red, green, blue. So these electron gun will emit the electrons which are of red, green, and blue color. So the image which will be formed will be a combination of these three colors. In shadow masking techniques, in between the electron gun and the screen, we are having a shadow mask which is having a holes. So the electrons which will be generated from this electron gun will go through with this shadow mask, and they will form a triangular dot in the screen. We can adjust this shadow mask to find or to create the image according to its intensity. So the electrons which will be generated by these electron gun will go through with these holes, and we can adjust also them, and then they will generate an image on the screen. As it is having a basic colors RGB combination, so the complete color range will be formed from this shadow masking techniques. These three techniques are used in CRT to form the colored images. So these are for the colored image CRTs used.